just started pouring outside, and I love it. It's Sunday morning right now. I knew it was gonna rain. I was looking outside my window this morning, and I was feeling so lazy. I did not want to get up. It was really dark out still at like 8:30 in the morning, and I was like all cozy in bed. Also responding to some comments on the vlog here, but most of you have already seen, I'm doing Vlogtober, which means I'm going to be posting a video every day for the entire month of October. Essentially, Vlogtober is vlogging every day of October, which I do plan to do Vlogmas in December, and I truly will vlog every day that month. But this month, it's not as interesting, you know, my life in October. Christmas time, it's a little more interesting. So I will do more vlogs weekly, but I'm also going to be doing beauty videos, and I'll just be posting every single day. So I'm really excited to be doing that. And these are just a few other videos that went up this past week. I've been posting a lot lately. That's why I decided to do Vlogtober, because I'm pretty much already posting about 5 to 6 videos a week. So I figured I might as well do Vlogtober. Oh, you're getting a sneak peek. Well, by the time this vlog goes up, it's not a sneak peek. This is tomorrow's video. BoxyCharm and Sephora Play Unboxing. I had 3 Play Boxes and 2 BoxyCharms. So that goes up tomorrow. It's like uploaded but not posted yet. And these were the videos that went up last week. So. Hey guys. I'm laughing because of my hair. This is the first time I've done these little top knot things, and I feel like I look like Shrek. What do you guys think? Yeah, I totally look like Shrek. They're cute though, but I look like Shrek. Anyways, I did very natural makeup today.
You're probably wondering about my lip.
It's called Gone Grage from Maybelline, part of their Bold line. And I have lip gloss Leslie to blame for this purchase, because she mentioned it in a favorites, and I was like, I need that. Because it's just so fall, and it's so 90s and grunge. It really is. I think I'm going to end up changing my lip though, because I'm going to be going grocery shopping with Mama B, and this lip might be a little much for that. So I'm going to try one of my new Kylie lip kits out, and I'll be right back to show you guys. Okay, guys, so don't mind the PJs, by the way. I changed it to Dirty Peach from Kylie's lip kit. I think I like it better with the natural look today.
Guys, look at this. It is pouring again. I hate my yard. Don't pay attention to that. Look at this. I'm loving it. But I don't really want to leave the house now.
So I pinned them in a little bit more so they're not sticking out as much, and I like it much better. Hey guys, guess who I'm with?
Me! And I want to let you know that I received a Sonic little treat card from Anne. And Anne, I've had this in my purse for so long and haven't used it. But today, I've used it for my cherry limeade!
Yay.
Oh, but guess what?
They forgot the cherries again. And I got a Diet Coke with cherry. I just wanted something new today. And yeah, we're gonna go grocery shopping, but I don't know if you can tell, but it's still a rainy day out.
It's a rainy day.
Oh, and that clip from before was, we went to Total Wine, me and my stepdad, and we got growlers for the guys, some beer, had it filled up, and I got pumpkin ale to try. I don't know if I'm gonna like it, but if I don't drink it, they will. So we'll try it out later.
Right?
And that's it.
Thanks, Anne. Loving
it. Oh, yeah.
It.
Thanks so much, Anne. I don't even... You're probably like, what? You guys didn't use that yet? Because that was like probably a year ago.
I know.
But we do really, really appreciate it.
But
and
what a
we
nice
use
treat
it.
On a rainy day.
Yeah. Yep. It was a nice little surprise in her purse to find that. So we will see you guys later.
So I just reorganized my Bath & Body Works candle collection. As you can see, I have quite a few. actually replaced my summer stuff in the house too, like my cute little bee candles right there. The two orchids gave me that, Karen from the two orchids. I love those. And she also gave me this candle from Gold Canyon. But other than that one candle, all the rest of my candles now are Bath & Body Works. So in my home haul, I do end up showing you guys my little storage area, but I don't really, you know, go through my candles or anything. So I thought I'd show you here real quick and how I organize everything else up there. So I have 43, I just counted, Bath & Body Works 3-wick candles. 8 of those are summer. The rest are fall and winter scents. That is how obsessed I am with the fall and winter scents. And I'm gonna go through a few of these now. I just found out that this is my last leaves. I definitely need to get at least 2 more backups of leaves. This is my all-time favorite candle. I just burnt through one. You'll see it in my empties this coming month. And it's something that I always need to have backups of. So I'm really like worried about not having backups of that. Also, winter is pretty much my favorite Christmas scent. I think Tis the Season probably comes at a close second for me, and Marshmallow Fireside. But winter, I usually have more than one, but right now I only have one. So the reason I went through my collection and organized right now is because I pushed all the summer candles to the back, all the fall winter ones towards the front, and I wanted to go in through my collection and see which candles I have duplicates of. So the only candles I have duplicates of right now are Sweater Weather, which is another like holy grail candle for me. I'm actually burning one right now, so I kind of have 44 candles because one's burning. But so I love Sweater Weather. I also have 2 backups of Marshmallow Fireside and 2 backups of Ski Lodge, which I'm not sure if they'll end up bringing this back, but this was my favorite candle last year. It smells so amazing. I really hope they bring it back, but that's why I ended up getting a duplicate of it. I've definitely realized that I'm not into the super sweet scents as much as I used to be. If this had been a couple years ago, you would have seen a ton of pumpkin cupcake candles and a ton more like bakery scents like these. These are the last bakery kind of scents I have in my collection. Everything else is not really that sweet. So let me put this back up. This one's kind of sweet, but it has like a berry tone to it, like, so it doesn't really smell that overpoweringly sweet. Same thing with Frosted Cranberry. It is sweeter, but not too much so. So yeah, that's my collection, guys. If you want me to do a whole video on this, I can, but I just wanted to show you really quick. So Pumpkin Pecan Waffles is my favorite sweet bakery scent for the fall. I don't know why, I'm just not feeling burning that right now, and I only have one left. I usually also have a backup of this. For some reason, I have 2 Pumpkin Spice Cheesecake. When I bought this one this year, I thought I had already burnt through my last one from last year, but apparently not. So I do feel like when I smell these, this one smells different than the new one. This one smells a little more like graham crackery crust smelling than this. This smells just like cheesecake. So, and this one I really, really love. This is actually from last year, and I didn't repurchase one this year though because it is more sweet. So, I don't know. I just don't like the sweet scents as much anymore, weirdly. This one I've never burnt, and I don't think they brought this back. This was from like 2 years ago, I think. Pumpkin Gingerbread. It smells so good, but I haven't burnt it yet, so I don't know how the throw is. Quickly, I'm gonna go through the remainder of my foaming hand soap. So I have the Coconut Pumpkin Latte, the new pumpkin butter soaps. This one's either from last year or the year before, Cozy Vanilla Cream. It's so yummy. I had a couple backups of that, but I've gone through a few. Crisp Morning Air. Pumpkin Pecan Waffles. This smells amazing as well in a soap, and I have one in my bathroom right now. And these two are for Christmas, Frosted Cranberry and Winter Wonderland. And then I do have 4 summery scents back there, but I pushed them towards the back because I won't be using them right now. I probably will go through all these soaps this year. Maybe 4 out of 6, I'm guessing. I go through at least 1 every month, sometimes 2. I wash my hands a lot apparently because I live alone and I still go through them pretty quickly. Okay, also I have my bulbs in this little
fabric bowl. I don't have very many fall scents. A lot of these are summer scents. All of those are summer scents. So these are the only ones I have left over for fall. I have two leaves, one autumn, and I have two sweater weather as well that I'm going to be plugging into my walls right now. And then in that basket are all like my, what are these called? Like the bulb holders that plug in, like I have for different seasons. I have a few different like snowflakes, and then I also have like the car freshener little things up there too. I switch those out every once in a while. Like I have one for Christmas and one for summer. And then in here I have like different soap holders and different candle holders. But as you can see, like those two are for fall, but these are for Christmas time. That one right there, the snowflakes, this one is for Christmas time. This one is for all year round. But yep, so that is my collection. Hope that wasn't boring. I thought you guys probably would be interested to see where I store my candles and what it looks like. I'm guessing you probably want to see the whole collection, but I might just have to do a separate video for that. But just wanted to quickly show you. Look what came in the mail just now. So I ordered the color wheel from Tarte. And obviously this is part of their holiday for 2016. I love that they carried over the beautiful packaging. Is this scratched? Are you kidding me? Are you seeing this right here? Well, apparently my packaging isn't perfect. That kind of ticks me off. But anyways, the packaging is carried over onto the palette. I'm trying to like open this one-handed. As you can see, it's about as big as my hand. And you get 10 shades. This side is more of like a warmer pinky and corals and like a golden highlight kind of shade. And then there is a piece of plastic that's connected in the center. And then here are the more like mauve-y colors, a little bit deeper coloring. They seem very, very beautiful. So I'm not going to swatch them in this vlog because I am going to be doing a review on it and I want to take pictures of it before messing it up. That really ticks me off. Look at that. Really, Sephora? Really? Anyways, I also got this little sample of the Too Faced Mascara Melt Off. Very curious about this because if this would help remove my mascara without having to like, you know, really kind of rub up my eyes, this will be amazing. So we shall see. By the way, sneak peek of my little giveaway package that I'm giving you. There's not much in it yet, but just show you a little sneak peek. Mostly Bath and Body Works stuff so far, but I definitely want to add one or two more things, plus makeup. I have to go through my makeup stash of giveaway stuff for you guys. And then I'll be filming it this week probably. Okay, don't fall over, popcorn. Hey guys, so you are gonna laugh. I just went to Starbucks and it's 9:30 at night to get a chai latte with 2 pumps of pumpkin. By the way, I get a non-fat chai, but then I get 2 pumps of pumpkin, so pretty much supplementing the calories, I guess. This probably won't keep me up all night, but I've been editing and responding to comments for hours now, and I just needed to get out of the house, and I haven't had Starbucks in a week and a half. I know, right? That's a long time for me. Okay, so anyways, Pixie sent me a package, and I'm really excited because most of these products I have not tried from them. So the first thing I'm really excited for is this Nourishing Cleansing Balm. It has sweet almond oil and cocoa butter in it. It's, you know, cleanse off balm instead of an oil, and it's a decent size. So I'm very, very excited about this. Here's what's inside of it. And this goes for $22. You can find Pixie at Target. I'm not sure where else. Online, I know, but Target is the place that comes to mind for Pixie. This is something I have tried. I've tried a full size. This is like a deluxe size of it, I believe. It's their Glow Tonic Toner. It has 5% glycolic acid, aloe vera, and ginseng. And the 100 mil, which is this the 100 mil? Yeah. This 100 mil bottle goes for $15. I've tried this before. I liked it, but I still don't understand why everyone raves about it so hardcore. It's nice, but I don't know. It's obviously I've never repurchased it, so I'll try it again and see how I feel now. Another skincare product is this rose oil blend with rose and pomegranate oils. I think I'm the most excited about this. I'm really getting into using oils to moisturize my skin again. Let's see. Rose oil, pomegranate oil, and rose geranium oil. Very, very interesting. So this goes for $24. And then there's this beauty. Look at that. I think that's a blush and highlight duo, right? Blush duo. Yeah, I'm guessing that's a highlight, or you could swirl them together. And it comes with a cute little kabuki. And this little set is $18. Yeah, it does say blush and highlight duo. I'm looking at this little paper here. So I'll have to swatch that for you in a moment here. Then there's this really cute little makeup bag. Oh my gosh, I don't think this is for sale because they don't have it listed. Look how cute that is. When I used to work for Sephora, we had to have clear makeup bags like this to display the products, you know, we're bringing in to the store and they have to check us in and out. So I would have loved this working at Sephora. And it's rose gold, the zipper. Very, very cute. And then last but not least is this Lip Lift Max in the shade Honey Sheen. And these go for $14. It says volume maximizing lip treatment with peptides to hydrate and plump. Plump. Come on, come out. Ooh, that's pretty. I was expecting it to be clear for some reason, but that's a beautiful like nude color. Okay, let me swatch these real quick. Okay, so here we have the swatches. There is the lip gloss. It does have a little tingle, very slight. It's minty, and you can see it's a nude, but it's kind of sheer, and it feels really good. I just put it on. It's not sticky whatsoever. And then you have the highlight and blush swatch separately. You can see that blush is essentially a highlight. Like, that is a lot of glow for a blush. But I did swatch them together on bottom there, and I think I like them, at least my first impression, I think I like it better swatched together. It gives like a peachy, glowy, really glowy blush. So if you want to be glowy, glowy, then you're going to love that. And by the way, the Kabuki brush is really, really soft. I'm actually very impressed at the quality of the little Kabuki. It's nice to have in your purse. All right, guys, that's it for tonight. Oh my gosh, let me show you one more thing. I gave myself a paper cut today, really bad, opening my Sephora box. So I have this cute little lip Band-Aid on. Pretty sure one of you sent me these Band-Aids in a care package, and I just think it's so dang cute. You guys, I am seriously so exhausted. Oh my gosh. So today consisted of me getting all ready, you know, straightening my hair, doing my makeup with the Nubian palette, by the way. Did a teeny, teeny wing, which I haven't done little wings in forever. Demi Wispy Lashes. So, you know, I took my time getting my makeup on. Planned on filming 3 videos today. Then I get a call from my mom saying that a nurse is coming to see my grandma at the house and if I could go over. Which of course I obliged because my grandma is more important than filming. By the way, she's home. Thank you so much for all your prayers. She's still going to be in recovery for a while. So just at home though. So that's good, in the comfort of her own home. Anyways, so I go over there and the lady was supposed to come by 1 o'clock. 2 o'clock rolls around, 2:15, still not there. So I call her and she's like, I'm 5 minutes away. She's kind of like snarky. I'm like, huh, you're 1 hour and 15 minutes late, biatch. So gave her the benefit of the doubt. She comes in with no supplies, no gloves, no gauze, no bags that she needed to bring. I don't know how she thought she was gonna do her job. Luckily, we had all those products because we were prepared, you know, to do it on our own when the nurse is not there. I don't know if she was new. I want to give her the benefit of the doubt to say that she was new. I don't know if that's true or not, but she didn't know what she was doing whatsoever. If I hadn't have been there, she would not have done what she needed to do. So I'm really glad I was there to assist. Literally, I was a nursing assistant today. Like, I was pretty much
helping her with her job, which shouldn't be. Like, she should know what she's doing. Oh my goodness, the worst, like, I don't even want to get into it because it'll be like totally TMI to you guys, but just know it was just like a hell of a day with that. My poor grandma, and my grandma's like, I do not want her coming back here again. You literally told her what to do and she's the nurse and I don't feel comfortable. Like, I don't trust her when you can't be here for me. And I was like, so I had to call, then I had to call the office and like tell them, I'm so sorry. Like, she was a very nice lady, but you know, this is what happens. And we don't feel comfortable with her coming back, so they are gonna give us a new nurse next time, and hopefully she'll know what she's doing. I don't know. I can get off on a whole tangent on that right now because I have a big feeling that the company that their insurance is using is not the best. It's probably cheaper than other services. Because I looked them up and they don't have the greatest reviews. So I feel like I definitely need to be there every time the nurse is. Which I think will be about once a week. So, anyways, we're, you know, slowly but surely getting somewhere with that. And I'm just really glad I was there for my grandma. Then my grandpa had some stuff for me to look at. I needed to, like, call the cable company for him and stuff like that. So I was there for about 4 hours. And, mind you, zero filming. Got done at that point. So I rushed home, filmed my September favorites, and filmed a lip swatch holiday kit review for you with the Tarte lippies and the Bare Minerals, so those should be up very soon. And hopefully the videos turn out good, because I feel like I'm just like low energy, so hopefully the videos don't come off that way. But I'm gonna go upload those to my computer and start getting to move on the editing. I'm so behind today, and I'll talk to you guys a little later. So today I'm trying out more of the Too Faced Grand Hotel palettes. And this is the eggnog one. I'm going to be doing my review very, very soon for you guys. But today I'm using this palette. I use Skinny Latte in my crease and Cold Brew on my eye. It reminded me a lot of the Urban Decay Shadow in the Diamond Dog. And swatch them both on my hand for you. And they're definitely not exactly the same. Diamond Dog from Urban Decay is on the right and Cold Brew is on the left from the Too Faced palette. But you can see why I thought that they were very similar. The Urban Decay one is a bit darker of a base and it sticks a little bit easier on the eye because it kind of has a slippery feel to it. Whereas this is, the left is the Too Faced, that one is more powdery feel. And it's very, very beautiful though. If you use a tacky base, it does show up really, really well. And I'll talk about that more in the review, but this is probably one of my favorites from the Too Faced collection because Diamond Dog is like a holy grail for me. I absolutely love it. So yeah, just thought I'd share that. Guys, so I just finished my makeup. You've seen this eye look a lot unless you're newer to my channel, but I used to wear this a lot. It's Diamond Dog from Urban Decay with some shadows from the Too Faced new hotel. What's it called? I keep forgetting what it's called. I keep wanting to call it Le Grand Chateau because that was last year's, but I think it's Le Grand Hotel. I don't know. Something, the Christmas Hotel palette from Too Faced, which hopefully I will have a review up. I don't want to say this week, it might be early next week, because I do have a few more videos planned for this week. Today is Tuesday. No, today is Wednesday. I lost a day. And I have my September favorites. I have to finish editing and it will go up today. And then tomorrow, I think I'm going to post my haul. And then Friday, my goal is to have the house tour up by Friday. But then again, I might want to post this vlog too. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, so you're probably wanting to know the rest of my makeup. So the blush, bronzer, and eyes, except for Diamond Dog, is all the Too Faced palette. On my lips, I have this Tory Burch lipstick that I actually got at Nordstrom Rack. So you might be able to find it there. And it is called Ramble on Rose. And I think it's a beautiful, beautiful nude pink. I think it goes really well with a smoky eye like today. I did go a bit warmer on the cheeks than, I don't know. I went with like a coral blush instead of a pink because the pink in this palette, oh my goodness. I will never wear that blush, telling you right now. maybe in combination with another blush, but that is bright as if. Bright AF, yes, definitely. I don't wear pinks like that, ever. And I'm actually thinking about doing a declutter series again because I'm going to be reorganizing my makeup collection and my makeup room because I will be filming a separate room tour for my makeup room as well as a makeup collection. I want to have that up probably in November because I still have a lot of work to do. Maybe at the end of October as part of Vlogtober. I don't know at this point. It just depends on how quickly I can get it organized. And I'm just noticing that there are quite a few like blushes and lipsticks that I really need to do a declutter for. I've never actually done a declutter of my blushes or my lipsticks. I've done gloss, bronzer, foundation, and highlights. So I think it's about time. I might also do the same with my skincare, like backup stock that I have. Yeah, I've got my work cut out for me when it comes to that. All right, guys, you guys are good. I know y'all are gonna kill me, but I couldn't resist getting this absolutely beautiful wreath from Big Lots today. I was looking for a beautiful silver kind of themed wreath like this for the last 2 years, so I'm really excited to have found this, and I had to grab it. I'm just putting it in my little Christmas wreath holder that I have. But yeah, this is so pretty. I love it. So I also got these beautiful candle holders with gems. They're for Christmas, but I'm gonna have them out all year round. That's why I love Christmas time, because a bunch of beautiful blinged out silver stuff comes out and on discount because it's holiday decor, it's considered, you know? So I always find stuff for my home during the holiday time as well. So these are absolutely perfect. I'm putting them in my bedroom. And I also got these candles with bling and sparkles. Aren't they beautiful? And they're actually the electronic kind of candle. So here's how it looks when it's on. And I like that it looks white instead of yellow. The light bulb that they used is like more of like a bluish white, and I like that a lot. So I'll show you that in my room in a moment. Well, I maybe should have read this, because I thought these were napkin rings and they're actual little mini candle holders. So I'm probably going to return these. I think, let's see how much it was. $4. I mean, they're not that expensive. Maybe I will use them somewhere, but yeah. Oh my God, that's so silly. I didn't realize they were little mini candle holders. Anyways, I also got these ornament hooks because I always run out of these or lose them, and they were only $1. So I thought I'd just go ahead and grab them now. I also went to Joann Fabrics because I'm thinking of doing like more of a backdrop in my videos, especially my tutorials. And I ended up getting two kind of bling fabrics. This is the other one. Just because I know those will work well in videos because I've seen it work in other people's videos. So I'm hoping this works out. You'll probably see it in the near future. I just got a yard of each and I had a 40% off coupon. Okay, and this came in the mail today from L'Oreal. How freaking cute is this? They're promoting their new Voluminous Feline Mascara. And they sent mine in Blackest Black. Woohoo, I love that. And the brush looks really interesting. They also sent me their Voluminous Noir Liner. That looks pretty. So, and then it came with this cute little kitty cat. Look, it has a little puff even on the side. Little makeup case, and that's where the little items were located. And then this cute little beanie that says Feline Meow. So cute. Thank you so much, L'Oreal. They have been really generous this year, and I've been loving trying out their products. Okay, also, This came in the mail, and I know you guys have probably seen a ton of unboxings of this, but unfortunately, Pure, my box got lost that they sent me, and so they resent it to me, which was so nice of them. This is their limited anniversary edition of their 4-in-1 Pressed Mineral Powder, because they've been around for 10 years, woohoo! And it's $34, and the chisel brush is $25. So let me go ahead and open this beautiful blingy box. Look at that, how pretty. And I just had a little information booklet here. So they sent me two shades, light, and this one I believe is in medium, golden medium. I think it's definitely going to be too dark for me, but oh my gosh, look at this. All blinged out. So pretty. Okay, hold on. I will open this for you. Yeah, that's probably going to be too dark for me. Maybe if I self-tan, I can use that because it is kind of a neutral golden. I've actually never tried their powders, the 4-in-1 powder before. Let's see if the light shade is better. And this is the little brush. It's kind of stuck in there, but it's like a flat top brush. And this is the light shade. I think that will work out much better for me. So I will get back to you guys on that, but I've heard rave reviews about this. So I really have no doubt that I'm going to enjoy it. So I love how I filmed my house tour and I'm already changing decor in my room. But I guess you'll just, so my setup will be a little different in my home tour. But here is my little setup in my room. And there's the two new candles. I love it. And I really love this stand. I put all my perfumes on it. It's from, I got it at Home Goods. Okay guys, so don't worry, I'm parked. I'm sorry I didn't show you my makeup when I looked all Christmassy and cute. Earlier, I filmed the Too Faced holiday set, but I just wanted to show you my eye look. And this is that Too Faced lip again. It's fun. It's like a warm gold look. Oh, I need to move out of the space. Just kidding, I am driving. Don't worry. I'm paying attention. But I'm just in my grandparents' community. Well, technically it's my parents and my grandparents' community, because my grandma called me and she needs help. You know, she's recovering still, and she needs a lot of help still, so I rushed. I finished filming my video, she called me like right when I was finishing, so I finished that, got changed real quick, and now I'm here. So I'm gonna help out my grandma real quick, and then I'll probably just go over my parents and do some editing. Okay, I'll talk to you guys later. Okay, don't mind my nose being so red because I literally just itched the crap out of it. But I just want to tell you guys that oh my God, totally forgot. Girl on a Train movie is so good. You definitely need to go and see it. I haven't gone to the movies in like forever, and I went tonight and it was really good. Like the first third of the movie, you really just have to like pay attention to the characters, like bam moment of the movie. Well, that takes a while for it to get to that point, but when it does, oh my gosh, like everything starts coming together and just like starts snowballing, and it's so good. So I really think you guys should see it. And I actually went with Mama B and she loved it too. Sorry we didn't vlog. We both weren't looking really vlog appropriate, but now I'm still vlogging anyway, so is what it is. So I think this vlog's gonna be really hella long, so I think I might end it here. It's Friday night, by the way. And I really hope you like it. And I'll see you tomorrow.